Hi, I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craftroom, and in this video I'm going to make another art journal page for my mini album. And this is the mini album. I made it from scratch and I got lots of viewers ask about it. It's almost filled, and then I will do a flip tour of the album if you like that, so let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. So let's start with the page. I add some lines with the masking fluid, and this is easy as it is in a bottle and I had some in a jar before. And that was a bit more challenging to use because it messes up your brushes if you don't clean them right away. Now, I sit pretty far from the kitchen or sink, so I basically have to run. And you need water and some soap to clean your brush, so a little bowl of water won't do. I'm going to use Nouveau Aquafaux pens, and these are from two different sets. I start with adding color in one box of space, and I color along the edge of the masking fluid, and then I come in with a water brush and I blend and I spread the color a bit. It's okay if you go over the edge a bit, add some water and blot to take away the color. Aquaflow ink reacts to water, so you can take it off again. I clean the brush in between on some kitchen paper and I just go over it a few times, and then the tip is clean. I just keep adding the colors and spread and blend them with a water brush. And I'm just adding the color randomly. I had no real plan, I just wanted to use the three colors. And just so you know, I added the main products I used in the description box for you, and you can find a full list of supplies on my blog. And if you're new here and you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe. And when you do so, you may like to click the little notification bell next to the subscribe button under the video, so you don't miss a thing. I let the page dry and then I can remove the masking fluid. I just peel it off with my finger, rubbing and pulling, and it comes off nicely. And while you are here, have you seen the community tab at the top? I will share new and fun things there, like behind the scenes polls and such, so you can check that out if you like. If you have no idea where the community tab is, you are not the only one. I show it at the end of a previous video and I will link to that at the top. I'm going to stamp with Distress Oxide ink in a light blue color, and I stamp with my hand. I just hold it and press it lightly in different places, so you get different parts of the stamp on the page. I also turn the page so it's stamped in different directions. I'm going to use my stamping tool, and I use watercolor paper, and that has some texture, and I want to stamp the stamp to be a nice crisp image. I add the magnets in the corner of the page and then I add the butterflies, and I move them around a bit to see where I want them. I added a bit of glue with a glue stick and I'm going to stamp the butterflies a few times to get a nice dark image. And then I add a clear embossing powder and I'm going to melt it with the heat tool. I'm going to take away some color with the water brush and then I'm going to add more color with the aqua faux pens in the same color. And this way the butterflies will stand out a bit more. I just add water and then blot it again with some kitchen paper to take off the color. I stamped a few splats with a stamp from the butterfly set and I forgot to film that. I used black archival ink and I'm going to stamp the sentiment with the stamp tool with the same ink so I can stamp it a few times if needed and to get a nice dark image. I let the ink dry and then I cut it to size and I add a doodle line with a black fine liner. I distress the edges, this way it won't show if you didn't cut straight. And I add some foam tape on the back and I add it to the page. And I wanted a bit more black on my page, so I'm going to stamp some more with the book page stamp. I have a torn paper and I'm going to stamp on the edges. I just put the torn paper on the page and stamp so I get a fun border. I just want the image here and there, so I press in different places a bit more and less so I get a darker and lighter images. And this is the finished page. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe and make sure to keep on crafting.